Today I have a new subject, although we have not finished those two subjects. One was sermons about Yawm al-Din, and the other one, the concerns of the Prophet Muhammad and things related to the traditions of Holy Prophet. But last night I thought about the occasion. Now today is the transfer of power in this country, and so many ceremonies going on at this moment that we are talking in Washington, D.C. At the same time, this week was the week of Martin Luther King honoring his struggle for justice. At the same time, last Saturday, we honored the departure of a great Ayatollah, Hashemi Rafsanjani, Quddisa Sirru, and he was a voice of justice, made hundreds of Friday prayer sermons on social and economic and political and moral justice during the last few decades. So for that reason, and today is inauguration of the 45th president of this country, who made it clear in his first victory speech when he said that he will deal fairly with everyone. So he talked about justice in his first presentation after the victory. So how really the issue of justice is going to be handled after all these ceremonial swearing services and calling it magic power and all of this media maneuver. Before coming to the khutbah, I was watching TV, and I remember this verse, يَعْلَمُونَ ظَاهِرًا مِنَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. They are focused on appearance of this dunya. And I remember this verse from the Quran, وَمَا هَذِهِ الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا لَهْوٌ وَلَعِبٌ وَإِنَّ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةَ لَهِيَ الْحَيَوَانِ. That this dunya is just all amusement and entertainment and celebration, and it is not true. Well, even in today's presentation, he promised to serve the nation and be equal to everyone. We hope that this time he is not exaggerating, because we have a history of President Trump talking a lot and lying a lot. I mean, he made big lies in the last few years. I mean, today I saw him and President Obama, they are shaking a hand, and he is the same guy that till recently was saying that Obama was not even born in this country. I mean, a big lie like that. Or on 9/11, Muslims were celebrating in New Jersey. So I hope that now that he has the power and he is settled in the White House, he has stopped those kind of statements and exaggerations and be truthful, be a truthful Trump, and not reminding us of the history of last few years. So today I'm going to talk about the issue of al-adala, justice, in our philosophy and in our moral values. We have heard those four words, al-hikmah, wisdom, al-shaja'ah, courage, al-iffa, modesty, al-adala, justice. So these four words were not only in Plato philosophy, but in Al-Ghazali, and also the Muslim traditions. Plato used to say that for a society to be beautiful, that society must be just. If there is no justice, there is no beauty. If the society is unjust, then it is ugly. Now, what is the definition of justice? Is justice definition is equality? Does justice mean fairness? Does justice mean balance? In the book of creation, التكوين, العدل التكويني, وضع شيء في موضعه, justice in creation means that everything be in the right place where it's supposed to be. In the book of Revelation, justice means إعطاء كل ذي حق حقا. Everyone receives his or her rights. Or every being in this creation receives what is right for that being to deserve to receive that. That is justice. So if there is justice in the society, we have everything in the society. If there is justice, there is freedom. People can think freely, they can talk freely, they can act freely, they can get together freely. If there is justice in society, there is peace in society. People are healthy, people are happy, people are loving and prosperous if people live under justice. And for this reason, one of our usul al-din in Imamiyya school of thought is justice. Al-adl is one of the principles of Imamiyya school of thought. Even when we talk about Al-Hussein alayhi salam, and Ashura, Karbala was about justice. Imam Hussein went to Karbala to establish justice. When we talk about Imam al-Mahdi alayhi salam, we are talking about justice. When we talk about the Quran, إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان. Justice is an order. اعدل هو أقرب للتقوى. Piety is about justice. وإذا حكمتم بين الناس فاحكموا بالعدل. فاحكموا بالعدل. Judgment must be based on justice. When you judge, be fair. وَإِذَا قُلْتُمْ فَعْدِلُوا When you talk, be fair in your talk. When you write, be fair. كَاتِبٌ بِالْعَدْلِ Writing with justice. When you deal with your family, وَإِذَا خِفْتُمْ فَإِنْ خِفْتُمْ أَلَّا تَعْدِلُوا فَوَاحِدًا Even in marriage, justice matters. So justice is the foundation of our faith. وَتَمَّتْ كَلِمَةُ رَبِّكَ صِدْقًا وَعَدْلًا Truth and justice are the main features of Allah's revelation, Allah's message. And when you go to Ahadith, there is like an ocean. الْعَدْلُ قِوَامُ الرَّعِيَّةِ الْعَدْلُ جُنَّةُ الدُّوَلِ عَدْلُ سَاعَةٍ خَيْرٌ مِّنْ عِبَادَةِ سَبْعِينَ سَنَةٍ العدل زينة الإيمان وحياة الأحكام The foundation of faith and society and government and law and order The essence of all of this is justice This is why somebody like George Ordaq He admires Imam Ali Although he is Christian But he says صوت العدالة الإنسانية I admire Imam Ali because he was voice of justice قتل علي في محراب عبادته وعدالته. When he was martyred, while he was praying, it was not only mihrab al-ibadah, in place of prayer, but also place of fairness and message of justice. For this reason, we and a group of interfaith community, we honored Martin Luther King. Just a few days ago, Martin Luther King was a Christian pastor, but we honor him because he also was a man of justice. And for that reason, he was killed in 1968. Almost 50 years ago, he was killed. He was only 39 years old then. If he was not killed, today he would be 88 years. I mean, still possible that somebody lives 88 years. And can you imagine if a man of that capacity was not killed, and if he was able to continue that movement against discrimination and racism and injustice, what would be the situation of not only the United States, but the entire world? I was just going through some of his lectures and writings in the last few days. And although it was not originally in my mind to talk about justice today, but then that, as a matter of fact, promoted me to make this decision last night to choose this subject out of hundreds of lectures and letters and books and expressions. There are few of his lectures that they are eternal. Like when he said, "I have a dream lecture." That is only 17 minutes of talk, but amazing. They consider that as the best lecture of the 20th century. Isn't that amazing? In 1999, I mean 1 year before the beginning of 21st century, when 300 of scholars met to vote for the best speech of 20th century, they voted for Martin Luther King, 17 minutes talk, "I Have a Dream." There was another lecture that he made it 1 year before his martyrdom. When he made that lecture, 1 year later, the same day, the anniversary of that same lecture, he was killed. And that lecture was about war in Vietnam, that he stood against war in Vietnam under Beyond Vietnam. There was another powerful presentation, "God is Marching On." And among the writings, the letters that he made, I was so touched by the letter that he wrote from a jail in Birmingham, that he was there for a while, he was in jail. And he wrote a letter, a long letter, to the clergy community about the issues, including justice and racism. So really, the voice of this man, this pastor, this doctor, the voice of justice, tells us really that, you know, we feel of being the same family of people of that kind of understanding. So we consider somebody like Martin Luther King to be a Muslim in a spirit, because he is representing what all the Anbiya, All the Anbiya came here for what? لِيَقُومَ النَّاسُ بِالْقِسْطِ. For establishment of justice. That was the mission of Moses, Jesus, Muhammad, Abraham, Noah. All of them came based on the Quran for one word. Al-Qist, Al-Adl, for justice. And this is why a Christian honors Imam Ali, because he was voice of justice. And we admire Martin Luther King because he was a voice of justice. I really advise everyone to read some of his lectures and letters. They're available online. When he said, injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. That is in his letter from Birmingham. There are two types of laws, just and unjust. Any law that uplifts human responsibility is just. Any law that degrades human personality is unjust. And he said, oppression, oppressed people cannot remain oppressed forever. Let us hope that the dark clouds of racial prejudice will soon pass away and we celebrate brotherhood and unity. In his lecture about Vietnam, he said, a time comes when silence is betrayed. We are called to speak for weak, for the voiceless, for the victims of our nation, and for those it calls enemy. So far, we may have killed a million of them, mostly children, in Vietnam. You stood against that 1 million people were killed by our bombs in Vietnam. We cannot be silent. What do they think as we test our latest weapons on them? Somehow this madness must cease. We must stop now. I speak as a citizen of the world, not only citizen of the United States, citizen of the world. These are calls of 50 years ago, 55 years ago. Then he, in another presentation under God, our God is marching on and he wants everybody to march. Let us march on the ballot boxes. Let us march. Let us march. And then somebody told him, how long we must continue to march? He said, not long, because no lie can live forever. Isn't it beautiful? No lie can live forever. And because you shall reap what you sow, for that reason is not going to be long time. And of course that very famous I have a dream that was given in front of the Lincoln Memorial in 1963 in Washington DC, in the same area that today this ceremonial transfer of power is going on. He made that I have a dream lecture in the same location, and out of all of these paragraphs, I have a dream, I have a dream, I have a dream, one of them was this, that I have a dream that my four children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. You know, out of all the lectures of 20th century, that dream was number one. And out of the entire I Have a Dream lecture, this paragraph is number one, that I have a dream that my four children are not judged by the color of their skin, but the content of their character. Such a powerful message that 250,000 people on that day were listening to him. But this voice of justice could not be tolerated. People call him radical, people call him extremist. They stood against him. And this is why in one of his final lecture in April, when he talked about, I have been on the mountaintop, he said, like anybody, I would like to live a long life. But I'm not concerned about that now. I just want to do God's will. And he's allowed me to go up the mountain. And I have looked over. And I have seen the promised land. I may not get there with you. But I want you to know tonight that we as a people will get to that promised land. It's amazing at that time, over 50 years ago, when Martin Luther King made this promise that one day we will meet in promised land. At that time, no one thought that almost 40 years after that lecture, an African American, a person of color, would go to the White House for 8 years. No one even dreamed that at that time. But this happened. And today that man is leaving the White House, at least with the honor that he didn't have any personal scandal. And he spoke with wisdom. He spoke with honor. And his message always meaningful. Nobody had anything like a personal or family corruption about Obama. Of course, we expected him and many people to do more. He served the economy, he changed the economy that was broken before. Lots of contribution. But at the same time, he was accused by Donald Trump and others that he contributed to the establishment of ISIS and war in Syria and continuity of war in Iraq and tragedy in Libya, that he acknowledged that Libya was a tragic mistake that he made. But we don't know the situation in the White House, that how much president has power to handle these things. Now you heard Donald Trump today. It was a beautiful lecture, no doubt about that. That he talked about his own hopes and dreams. America number one, America great again. He talked about nation, he talked about it's your celebration, it is your victory. Jobs are getting better, security is getting better. And he talked about elimination of Islamic radical. I don't know what he really, he didn't mention ISIS, by the way. I was hoping that now that you're talking about ISIS, say it, what do you want to do about ISIS? He did not mention ISIS, he said Islamic radical. I don't know which country he has in his mind. And with all this radical, that he is showing radicalization, as a matter of fact. So what is his plan? Now, you were saying that Obama was a founder of ISIS. Are you going to put an end to ISIS in Bahrain, in Afghanistan, in Yemen, in Syria, in Libya? What is your plan? I hope that, as I said, we heard him already lots of lies, Trump, during the presidential campaign. But we hope that today, that now he's in power, he means it. When he talks about more prosperity and more peace for Americans, and he talks about the entire world, of course we are against radicalism as well. Radical Islam. It all depends what you mean by radical Islam. Do you think that, for example, Jesus was radical? Is it meaningful? Doesn't make sense to say radical Jesus or radical Moses or radical Abraham. Doesn't make sense. So radical Islam doesn't make sense either, because the same message. But if you mean the terrorists and those Al-Qaeda and ISIS, what is your plan? Are you thinking about more bomb and more war and more destruction? That is not the solution. The solution is not to put more bombs in Iraq and in Libya and Yemen. If you really mean it, if you want to eliminate that ideology of extremism and terrorism and barbarianism, the solution is very clear. Don't call nations that they are behind this radicalism and terrorism as your best allies. How can you fight ISIS through Israel and Saudi Arabia and, you know, the other guys in the area? They are the ones that are supporting ISIS. ISIS does not exist without their military and money and media. Stop that if you really mean it, and show your honesty, and then the nation be united against anything that is called injustice, whether in this country or anywhere. Quran is reminding everyone that the countries and societies and civilizations, they collapse because of injustice. They collapse because of corruption. They collapse because of ikhtilafat, lack of unity. They were corrupted because they did not support what is good and did not prevent what was evil. So our prayer today is that the new president, who is taking the key for the White House, he starts practicing what he is preaching and being honest, and as he promised to be fair to everyone. As a matter of fact, today we saw a rabbi there, and we saw a priest in a swearing ceremony, but we did not see an imam. The Muslims were not involved in today's ceremony in front of the White House, but we don't care about the ceremonial appearances. We care about the real issues, that is, this is a beginning of a person who is going to stand for justice, for truth, for people, and stand against discrimination and racism and hatred. Well, we have an opportunity. We have seen this president today. As a matter of fact, there were six presidents together. One of them was Bush's father, was not there, but it's amazing that this country, at the same time, six presidents still alive, and they participating. We have seen this at the time of Obama and Clinton and Reagan and Bush every 4 years. This is not the whole thing. This is just a ceremony that these people were fighting one another. Today we're kissing and hugging one another. And tomorrow, business as usual. Democrats are Democrats, and Republicans are Republican, and, you know, continuation of what the Quran says, هذه الحياة الدنيا لهو ولعب وإن الدار الآخرة لهي الحيوان. So people are busy with this entertainment. It's amazing that entertainment is not impossible. I mean, when Trump started this campaign, people said, this is a joke. Everybody thought that was an entertainment. But how entertainment works in this world, and it shows that nothing is impossible. Everything is possible. What we should do as Muslims, brothers and sisters, to get engaged, regardless of what happened and what is going to happen, for Muslim community to be prosperous, to move on, we need to be present. Our absence, our indifference won't help us. If you want to do anything, especially at this time that we are facing so many tahadiyat and so many challenges, we need to be on the scene. You see, even Clinton, Hillary Clinton, she was there today. Can you imagine after all this fighting and cursing one another? Because they know that no matter what, you have to get engaged. Your absence doesn't help you. That is a lesson for everyone. That no matter whether you agree or disagree, as Muslim community, we must be involved. We must be there. And this is why we, as a very humble and simple mosque, yesterday we had hundreds of students, Muslim and majority non-Muslims, from public schools. They came to House of Wisdom, and we had 5 hours from 8, 9 o'clock till almost 2 o'clock, 5-6 hours of engagement and orientation and question and answer, talking about Islam, what does Islam mean, who are Muslims, and be available to answer their questions, and sitting together and eating with one another and feeling that we are one family. And when you see these boys and girls, 7, 8 grades, they come to a mosque for the first time in their life and they hear about Islam, that is really the way. And I want to thank Wise Academy and Interfaith Leadership and the House of Wisdom staff for working together to putting such a beautiful orientation of Islam. You never know that one of those 200, 250 students who were here yesterday be in the White House one day. You never know. 50 years from now, 40 years from now, and at that time they remember, yeah, I remember one day I was at the Islamic House of Wisdom. We were there, and we had a lunch there, and we had a question and answer. So this is the way that humble, little here, little there, we can improve our situation and our community. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجعلنا من حزبه ومن جنده ومن أوليائه فإن أولياءه لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون وعلى الله فليتوكل المؤمنون ومن يتوكل على الله فهو حسبه عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون وإلى الصلاة إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله